Hey guys, myself Afan and welcome back to my YouTube channel Tech Fears. I hope you're going good, and in the last video we saw how to add content and image transitions to our website. So today we will see how to create cards using logos of some events. So here is what we are going to build in today. We will create a new section for this thing, and inside this section, if we consider this if we observe, we have these two rows, right, consisting of three cards each. So this is my first row, and over here this is my second row. So I'll be creating two division tags for each of them, and inside those two division tags we will be having three more division tags for each of those division. And let us see this practically. To do that, let me get into my Sublime Code. So here's my Sublime Code. I have created one more style sheet called cards.css. So here we will be coding for our cards part. And let me just create one more section. So I'll say section, and I will give it a class name called cards. And inside this section, as I told, I will use two division tags. With class name first, let me give it as row card 1. We will give it as card row 1, so that it will have some definite meaning. So I'll just copy this. Let me paste this again so that this defines two rows, each containing three cards. So inside this, I will be creating three cards, and as well as inside this, three cards as well. So one more division tag for each card. I will be having one more division tag. So division tag actually basically acts as a container over here. So we'll give it a class name called card, or else simply we can say it as event, because this card specifies the event names. So I will be giving it as event itself. Event, and inside here I'll be having an image, and I will give it a reference of that image. So inside my images, so dot slash, this represents that from my current directory inside my images folder, I am having one more folder called Eugen logo, and inside that I'm having these files. Let me open that and show it to you. Inside my images, I'm having this Eugen logo folder, and inside this, these are my files logos. So the first one, ansible.png. You can use any of the dummy images. Okay, so this is my image. Let me even give its width and height. I'll set the width to 150 pixel as well as height to around 150 pixels. So after that, I need to even mention the name for the event. So I will be giving it as Ansible itself. So let me copy this thing and paste it a couple of times more. So I've copied it two more times, and I will even change this name as well. So I will change it to say art station. Okay, now for this second row also, but before that, before going for the second row, let us see if this has been applied in our website. So when I refresh this, now I can see my logos have come over here. So I don't want these or just below each other. I want them in a line. So to do that, we already have seen the property called display inline block. So if I use display inline block for this event class, for all these event class, these all will cover only that much area of how much content it occupies. So I will go over here. Inside my cards, I am having this card row 1 class. So I will say cards. So inside that I am having this card row 1, and inside that I am having the card with name events. I have to mention a dot over here. So I have to just set the display property to inline block. So when I refresh this, it's not actually applied. Let us see if there is any mistake. It is not actually events, it's event. So I have to remove here. Now when I refresh and come back here, you can see all of my images have come just beside each other. Now I want all of these to be at the center. So to do that, I will copy this. So all my events to be at the center. This is my main row, right? So inside my main row, all of my three cards, that is nothing but the event, are residing. So I want these events to be center. So I have to go over here, and inside here I will say text align, and I will set it to center. So all my content will be centered. So refresh, and you can see all of my images have come to the center. Now simply I will design these cards. I will give a background color for this background color, and I will give it as black itself, black, and then let me even use some border radius to this as suppose 20 pixel. I will give it as 20 pixel, and when I refresh this thing, you can see my card's background color is been applied. Now you can see my text is been vanished. It's actually over here. You can see it's actually over here, but due to its color and the background color being the same, it is not being visible. So inside my event tag, I am now having my heading 3 tag. So I will simply change the color for this heading. I will set it to white. And now when I refresh this, you can see it is being changed to white. You can it is too congested, these cards. So let us give us some padding for these cards. I will give a padding around 10 pixel, as well as let me even give some margin as 10 pixels. So what this padding does, inside these cards it gives some spacing, so it increases the size, and whereas margin gives some spacing between the cards. So when I refresh, you can see my cards have been now bigger than the previous thing. So this margin, let me set it to 15 and see how it looks. It's looking the same thing. Let me give it to 50 pixel and see how it looks now. Now it's looking a bit good, 50 pixels of margin between all these cards. Now similarly, I have to design for the next 3 cards. So I will get back to my HTML document, and I will just copy all of these 3 cards. I have to simply now change the names as well as this PNG images. So here I used PortShafers. So I am remaining with these 3 files. So I'll quickly write on it. And now when I refresh this thing, now let me come back, and you can see my second row images. This has come this way, one below the other. The reason behind this is we have not applied the styling for our second row. So I just have to simply copy the same thing right over here, actually for the entire thing. Let me do that for the entire thing, and when I'll paste this down, and simply what we did for row 1, similarly we have to do this for row 2 as well. So row 2 here as well as row 2. And now we will refresh this thing and see if this is being applied. And you can see now these are being perfectly applied. Now, what again we have to see is when I hover, you see this shadow, right? As well as this card coming popping out. So to do that, we already know that we used hover property. So to do that, I will simply say yes. And now instead of giving row 2 and row 1, instead of that I can even directly give it as event. Not this. Now you might question me why directly events, because my event card is residing under card 2, either in card 2 or either in card row 1. So why I am giving this directly? If I give this directly, see, this is the direct hierarchy of HTML document. If I give event as the class name inside my cards, it will first search for the first child element. If this doesn't match, it will search for the second child element, and until and unless it gets its child element, it searches for it throughout its section tag. So if I give it event, it will directly go to its nth child element. So we are directly styling for all of those events. Instead of, we can even do this in this manner also by writing this way, but it's okay. It shortens our code by writing this everything for all of those events. We are giving the same styling as well. Now we have to simply say box shadow, and for this I will give 5 pixels shadow with respect to x, 5 pixel to y, and the width, how much the shadow should spread. Let me give it to around 15 pixels, and the width of the shadow, let me give it to 5 pixel as well. No, okay, let us give 5 pixel as well. And finally, the color of the shadow, I will give the RGB a color. So for black color, we have the RGB numbers are 0, 0 and 0. And even I have to mention the alpha property. So alpha property, as you know, this defines the how transparent that shadow should be, the color should be actually. So I will give it to around 0.7. So this much of transparency it should cover. So now when I go over here and refresh this thing, you can see my shadow has come over here, right? So let me give some size width for this. Let me give it to 10 pixels and refresh this thing. You can see my shadow has been applied, and they will even reduce its spread to 10. Now it's coming good perfectly over here. Now when I hover this, I want this card to be pop out. As you can see over here, this thing, when I hover, you can see this transition, like you feel like this card is coming out of the screen. So to do that, we have already seen it, we use the hover property for that. So I will simply write this down, and I will say hover, and instead I will increase the size here. I will say 10 pixel as well, and even increase the width to around 15. Refresh this thing. Not here. Now I can see the shadow has been spread. But one more thing we have to do is we have to use the transform property, and I will set transform translate with respect to y, and I will set it to around minus 5 pixel. So it should go minus 5 pixel with respect to y axis. So now you can see when I hover over this transition coming right over here. So now finally, what this background you see, though I have to use this background, we have already used this to of a header part. So over here I will simply go, and in my first style sheet I will copy the whole thing, this background. I will paste it and explain it to you. So I have to use it for my cards class. So this is my section with class name dot cards, and I will paste this background image over here. So what this will do, this is my main background image URL path. So inside my images, I have this college.jpg. This is my main image. So on top of that, I have applied this linear gradient color. This is the color code. This is actually light green and this is a bit dark green with some transparency of around 0.40% here as well to 0.040%. So this green gradient overlay will be applied from top left 00 to all to the bottom right bottom. So here you can see all over from here top left to all over till here right bottom, my linear gradient will be applied. So now this will be applied, but before this, when I refresh and show it to you, you can see my background image is repeating. So to avoid that, I have to write background repeat and I have to set it to no repeat so that my image should not repeat. When I refresh and see, you can see my image is not been repeating, but the thing is we don't have anything over here. It is covering only this much area because my image size is this itself. So I have to even say background size and I will set it to cover so that it will cover the entire background size. When I refresh, and now you can see it is covering the entire background size, and we have almost done. And finally, we have to see this thing. We have clipped this path right from here till here. We have already done this to our header part. So what we will do here is we will use clip path, and have this property called polygon. And let me show it to you. So here you can see this is my first point over here. So with respect to x and y, it will be 0, 0. And coming right over here, down here, you can see this point would be like 100% with x and 20% with y. So my this point would be 100 and 20. And finally, all over here, it would be 100 with x as well as 100 with y. So, and finally, my fourth point would be here. And this would be like 0 with x and 100 with y. So let me quickly do that. So my first point would be 0 and 0 as well with x and y, and second point this is my 100 and 20. So 100 with x, 100% actually, and not 30, I'll give it as 20% with y, comma, and the third point over here, it would be 100 with x as well as 100 with y. So I'll simply say 100% and 100%, and now finally this point over here, 0 with x and 100 with y, 0 and 100%. So let us see if this has been applied to our side. You can see this thing, and before that, let me give some padding over here. You can see we have some padding, right? We have some space over here. So to do that, I will simply say set some padding. I will set the padding to the top side of my section. So I will set it 200 pixel, and now when I refresh this thing, you can see my padding has been applied, as well as you can see this thing, my path has been clipped correctly. And that's it guys for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked it, and if so, make sure that you hit the like button. If any questions or any topic that you want me to cover, just comment down and I will make sure that I reach you. And in the next video, we will see how we can create an instruction table and even add some entry details. So to get some more content on these topics, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon. Till then, happy coding.